And published. I hope someone uses my networking library. Wait, I made a what? When? I wrote a lot of code, like a lot of code, in AMOS BASIC, a pretty advanced programming language made for the Amiga computer. Role-playing games, timed karaoke lyric playback, web browsers, and dozens of other things, either for myself or for publishing on the early internet. One of the things I wrote towards the end of my time on the Amiga was a very basic networking library. I got enough of it working to make a connection to a server on the internet, and then I stopped. But I published what I'd finished, and I moved on from using Amiga computers daily. But I never moved on in my heart. 23 years passed. I learned Perl, Java, Ruby, PHP, C++, Python, JavaScript, Clojure. I built web pages, mobile applications, web servers, desktop applications. And all that time, that library was out there, all alone, just waiting for someone to use it, to give it a shot, to see just how much young me knew about socket-based networking on the Amiga. Turns out I didn't know that much. Someone emailed me asking if I was the developer of this library, and upon looking at the cringe-inducing README and documentation, realized that, yes, I did write a semi-functioning networking library for AMOS in 1998. This person was trying to get two real Amigas to talk to each other, and the server part of the code did not work at all. Luckily, I had an Amiga emulator all set up from when I did the copper demo video. That was a research piece for a future Amiga video, or two, or six, or so I decided to see what I could do. I quickly realized that there were three issues. My copy of AMOS BASIC was missing pieces I had been using 23 years ago. I didn't know how the system library I was wrapping, the Amiga BSD socket library, even worked. And at the time, I didn't understand how to listen for network socket connections correctly. AMOS BASIC was feature-packed right out of the box, the literal box. But there's always room for improvement in programming languages. AMOS let skilled developers improve the language with extensions, machine language libraries that added new commands. Libraries are collections of computer code that do useful stuff for more than one program. In most cases, programmers make a library when they've realized they're reusing code between two or more places. All that useful, reusable code is smooshed together into one place, and there's typically another thing that describes, like a roadmap, how to get at each piece of useful code. AMOS BASIC has 26 extension slots. Looking at my code, I saw a lot of the use of extension 16 functions. What was extension 16? According to a handy list on the internet, there were two possibilities. One of them talks to a very specific type of bulletin board system. The other, useful functions for string processing. You've got the job! Next, I had to learn how the Amiga Berkeley Software Distribution Socket Library, the library I was using for network access, even worked. That was going to be tough, due to lack of documentation about the library, and due to how Amiga libraries get used in AMOS. Knowing how Amiga libraries work is important, so imagine a street with a bunch of businesses on it. You have a chore list and need to go to these businesses to complete your chores. You can carry a few items at a time into each of these businesses, and they'll either give you other items back, or send new items to a place where you can get them later. However, all the businesses are unlabeled. You don't know which is which. All you know is how many steps away from the start of the street each store is. You turn around and see a long, thin bulletin board with index cards. Each spot on the bulletin board is numbered by how many steps back from the start of the street that spot is, and each card has a number written on it. Confused, you stare at the board for a while, until a helpful passerby hands you a chart. The chart has the list of the names of the stores in the street, and which position on the board is for what store. They explain the card's number is how many steps from the start of the street that store is located. Now you can match store to index card to number of steps from the start and get to each store you need to go to. In normal Amiga development, that chart of store to index card is plugged right into the place where you're coding. You use the name of the store, and your tools know which card to use. AMOS can kinda do that, but either I couldn't get it set up right, or there was no way for me to set it up for the BSD socket library, so I just had to know how many steps back from the start I had to go to get to the correct index card. Problem 2 down. Finally, I got to the hardest piece, actually using the BSD socket library, making it so I could properly turn an Amiga into a server and accept outside connections. Unlike last time I worked on this, I had other machines on a network I could use to test. I won't go into all the details of socket-based communication, but I will cover the part I wrote incorrectly. Imagine you're a delivery person. You need to go to the big building downtown and drop off and receive a bunch of packages. You enter the building, the doors are wide open, and there's a front desk and a bunch of freight elevators. The person at the front desk verifies you're legit, then hands you a card with a number on it, the number of the elevator you're supposed to use. Then, the front desk notifies that elevator's operator that you're here and that the operator can help you get your packages in and out of the building. This is kind of how the server code should have worked. The way I wrote it, I set up the front desk, staffed it, and opened the building's doors. But when the delivery people arrived, I basically told them to leave their packages at the front desk. They didn't make it into the building, and no one, the delivery people or the elevator operators, knew what was going on. And the front desk person is entirely too busy dealing with delivery drivers to take packages in. A quick bit of docs reading, lots of saving my AMOS code because Amigas can crash like all the time, and a little testing with Telnet, and my server creation code was accepting messages from other machines, but not just on my local emulator either, but on real actual Amiga computers, whoa! So yes, I managed to fix a 23-year-old library I haphazardly wrote and barely tested, written in a language I hadn't used seriously in 23 years, so I could help someone get it working on actual physical Amiga computers. Up top, Agnes!